So we are done processing with the inventory. We're done messing with all that nonsense. We're done filming stuff for you guys. We're going on a walk.
Something that we did not do well at first when we started this was having a work-life balance.
Yeah.
I mean, I have to take care of him, and Sebastian, like, used to be up till 2 in the morning working on stuff.
Yeah.
So, like, we were not spending any time together, so we're really intentional about nighttime walks. If we can't go for a walk, we'll still hang out, because even if you work at home, you still have a family life. Mm-hmm. So, like, the ability to separate the two is going to make your life a whole lot easier, and it's probably going to make your spouse probably happier, too, so.
Yeah, kids, like, working at home is great, and you think, like, you're going to be all cutesy and all that stuff all day, and, like, in the movies, like, you're just, like, cuddling and lounging all day.
No.
Guys, like, that's not real. Like, sure, that's real if you're, like, a millionaire, like, a celebrity. Sure, yes, I get that, but if you're normal people that work from home, like, you literally still have to do the work part, or there won't be, like, a home part, so, like,
and also, if you don't learn how to do the work part, there's also not going to be a home part. Like, yeah. you have to learn how to work together, but also how to live together and to,
exactly,
like, maintain a healthy relationship. Even though you're, like, business partners now, it's hard, but it's totally doable. I think we do a good job.
We do a good job, and it's because of, like, years of nonsense. Like, we've gotten into arguments and just...
Spend more time with me!
Just, yeah, like, just... We had to talk about things. Like, yeah. If you can't talk about things with your spouse, then why are you married to them? You know, why are you dating them? Why are you pretending anything? So, yeah, this took years. All of this took years to build the business, the relationship, the marriage, the home.
Years, but I would say, like, none of it happened by chance. These are conversations that we had multiple times. Like, we're not connecting. We're not spending time together. There's not enough work getting done. We're not making enough money. Like, the ability to problem solve on, I guess, just like in a very well-rounded way, is going to either make it or break it for your business if you are working as a couple.
Yeah, I agree. It's being business partners is one thing, or being married is one thing, but being business partners is a whole another thing. Like, that comes with so many different challenges that most couples don't ever have to worry about. It's like, when we first started all this, this was 110% me. Cheyenne was not involved in eBay whatsoever. Like, she was working, she was doing her own thing. Like, I couldn't talk to her about it. Like, I would try to be like, hey, like, this is what our sales through is to the eBay store. And she's like, oh, okay. Well, like, the money's great, but there was no further interest in it. You know, there was no, what am I looking for to
if
say?
I'm
like,
being completely honest, I was not at a good place in my life. Like, I mean, I don't want to get too far into this, but, like, I had just left a cult. That's a whole story in and of itself.
Stay tuned for that. Follow just for that. Fuck.
I should title the video that. Escaped a cult to sell on eBay.
Heck yeah, that's clickbait.
That's actually a good one.
That's a great one.
But I was not at a good place. I wasn't at a good place to be a teammate, and honestly, I just wasn't a good partner. But it's not because I didn't want to. It's because, like, in my own mind, I was not doing so hot. Is where Sebastian was trying to build something. And so by the time I did finally get it together, like, there was already a business in place. It was hard for us to figure out how to do something together. So that was, like, a whole nother challenge in and of itself that we had to figure out. But we did.
And we're still here. And our marriage is doing better than ever. But the point of all this and the moral of all this nonsense is that working from home is great, but it takes a lot of intentionality, guys. That's why.
Yeah.
That's why most people, first of all, most people fail in small business endeavors. And second of all, most people can't work from home together with their spouse. It's a whole nother thing to, like, worry about, you know? Are you comfortable being around your spouse 24 hours a day? And, like,
do you
not
trust them?
Yeah, do you trust them? Like, do you need that 8-hour a day break from them? Like, that a job would get you, you know?
Is there enough humility in your relationship that if you were to have one of those hard conversations, how's it gonna go? If your answer is not so hot, well, then your relationship's probably not doing so hot.
Yeah, and, like, guys, I used to be, like, a toxic guy. I used to be, like, all mentally messed up. And if you want to kind of know part of that story, like, working at Cisco Foods just made me so depressed. I'll link to the video up there. I made a whole rant about it. It's kind of funny, but you should watch it. But I used to be one of those guys, like, oh, you can't tell me nothing, this and that. And, like, I wouldn't talk to my girlfriends and I would just ignore them. And, like, I'd always wonder why, like, relationships in high school and stuff, like, would never last. And it's because I was just a toxic, shitty dude, you know?
You were toxic and shitty. I was brainwashed.
She was brainwashed. Now we're trying to figure it out. through Resale Junkie, through everything we're trying to build here, through you guys, through helping everyone. We're trying to figure all this out slowly.
It's not even just a business venture, guys. Like, this to us is a very, it's very near and dear to us because it is so holistic. It took us addressing our own mental health. It took us addressing our relationship, our business, our finances. Mm-hmm. But the thing is, we were humble enough and we were intentional enough that we did it. It's not impossible. But both of you, mm-hmm. if you are going to be working from home, both of you need to be on board or it's not going to happen.
I guess that's the point of this video. We didn't even know that was there was going to be a point in this video whatsoever. That's a really good point. If you're in a relationship, you need to talk to your spouse and both of you need to be on board, because yeah. if 6 months from now you're like, hey, Cheyenne, I want to quit my job to sell used clothes, and that's the first thing that she hears about it, she's like, what are you talking about? Like, why? You know, you need to be open. You need to talk about all this. You need to talk about, like, she became a better cook because I told her she sucked at cooking. Mm-hmm. Guys, it's not that hard. Like,
and you know what? Objectively, he showed me technique and showed me where I was wrong. And I was like, oh shit, you right?
I was right, because I'm a better cook than her. And I told my wife she sucks at cooking.
Yes, and the ability to like take that feedback and say, okay, is there some truth to this? And if there is, there's no problem in admitting where you're wrong, admitting your faults, and growing in that experience. But I would say that that's like the biggest downfall with couples, the lack of humility, the lack of intentionality, and the lack of conversation.
And self-awareness. That's a big one.
And self-awareness.
It doesn't matter. Relationships, you can have all the relationship goals you want and see all the cute Pinterests and all that nonsense. But if you are not self-aware from the get-go, you will not survive in anything, whether it's sports, entrepreneurship, arts, crafts, anything you name it, relationships, like none of it will work unless you work on yourself first.
Uh-huh.
There's a reason why every rich person, why every guru, and why anyone successful in the world has always said that. Start with yourself first.
Mm-hmm.
It matters the most. Just like if you're on a plane and it's going down, help yourself and then go after the others, you know?
Transitioning into the business part of being self-aware too, like, yes, work on yourself. Know why you are the way that you are. Know your triggers, know your communication style, know your love language. All of that stuff. But when it comes to your business, also be aware of exactly where you're at. So that's going to come with listening to the gurus that have been where mm-hmm. you've been. If something's not working, instead of getting emotional and saying, oh, forget it, like this clearly isn't working, be aware in your business too. Know why things are failing. Ask questions.
Mm-hmm.
Like, try to find an answer instead of getting emotional about it. And exactly. I promise you're going to have a much better time.
Guys, like if you start a business, it's a very emotional endeavor. Like starting this whole eBay journey and like selling used clothes, like to you guys, it may sound really stupid and like small time and all that stuff, but
it's
like-
it's been incredibly emotional.
It's been incredibly emotional over the past few years. Like we had so many ups and so many downs and so much money made and so much money lost instantly. Mm-hmm. Like it's just been a crazy, crazy ride, but just taking the punches as we come and like just keeping going and mm-hmm. it's never stopping. We just never ever stop. That's another thing all rich people say, is the reason they make it is because they never stopped.
Mm-hmm.
There's a reason we're trying to post a video every single day for you guys. It's because we don't want to stop. We want to make it, you know, like that's
we're gonna make it.
We're gonna make some t-shirts. You guys should buy some We're Gonna Make It t-shirts. That should be our slogan, our catchphrase. We gotta trademark a lot of things here.
We do.
We're gonna wrap it up because my arm's starting to hurt. We are gonna enjoy the rest of this walk. Moral of the story, fix yourself. Know yourself. Be humble.
Be intentional.
Be intentional.
Don't be a dick.
Don't be a dick. That's
and
a good one.
Learn how to take criticism without getting your ego all hurt about it, okay? It's just a correction. Like grow up.
Exactly. And that is our key to success, even though we're not successful yet, but we are on a lovely walk when at this time of night on a Thursday afternoon, I would be in a hot, sweaty kitchen
mm-hmm.
getting ready to cook for all these customers that were gonna come to the restaurant I was working at. And she was at an event center taking care of weddings and it was miserable.
Mm-hmm.
So guys, there is
a
better way to live. There's greener pastures, there's all that good stuff. It's not that impossible. Like, again, we don't make that much money on eBay, but we're doing this right now because we're free. So, that was a good video. Hope you guys had fun. If you did, please, please, please like and subscribe. Hit the notification bell. All that good stuff really helps our little small channel grow. And then resellejunkie.com. There is a free beginner's course there that you can take and start your reselling journey today.
with us though.
That's it. Cheers.
Cheers.
That was great.